Hi guys, how are you doing? Some of my friends or those farmer or even the home grow that might facing a problem with doing the seedling, and also the percentage of grow is not that good. And some of the home grow, they are coming in to me and just asking me, I took the seed from certain places and then there is not doing well. Okay, there is many factor why the seed is not doing well, on the percentage of grow might be very low. First of all, I would like to share with you where the seed actually comes from. So the seed actually, it come from farmer, it come from the even the home grow that you're collecting your own, or even from the importer, some of the institute that they really grow, study, and then they're collecting the seed is just to giving away or even doing commission. And you also can get a lot from the shops and distributor. What happening is that when you want to choose the seed, besides the basic thing, like you have to check on the packaging whether the expiring date is getting too near or not. Those are the things that you might need to check definitely. But you also have to look into the environment as well. Don't buy the seed that they always keep or store it in the place that is direct sunlight or too much of the heat, or even next to the chemical. Those fertilizers, sometimes you know it can create some heat, and those heat actually is throughout the time, it will make the seed not so effective. Means that the good seed that you buy, the percentage of growth, it should not be lesser than 80%. Beside that, if or you look too into the what you want to buy, also is important. Let's say if you are doing for just a home grow, I would like to advise you to buy in a very small quantity that you can finish it up in no time, you know, grow it immediately. You don't need to store it for too long. What type is also is very important. So buy what you like to eat. That's very simple. If you just a home grow and then just for your kitchen use, so you like to eat what type, you just buy those, okay? But if you buy for commercial, also it's important that you need to check out the market needs as well, whether the markets they like which types, which variety, and also just buy according to your budget or the piece of land that you have, so you will not get the extra seed too much to keep. And if you're collecting your own seeds, certain things you need to know is that when you buy the seed, those the distributor, this is the original that coming in this way. So when you having the seed from there and collecting it yourself for the home grow is okay, because it will change slightly. It will not exactly the result the same time, same thing that you first lot that you grow. To keep all those seeds and preserving it also is important. Normally for the very big size of the seed, I will just dry it under the hot sun for a very quick one, and then move it indoor and let it a little bit drier a little bit for a day. I just keep it into the very dry and clean container and put it at the chiller, so that way the seed actually can last for about a year, but not advisable to keep over the year. So for those are very fine leaves, normally I will never let it touch the sun at all. So when I collect it, what I'm gonna do is that just air dry at the under the shade, so for a day or two. When it's dry nicely, I will just pack it at the same way. If you have it too small quantity, you can put into the wrap into the paper first, the clean and dry paper, and write the date will be advisable. You can keep track whether this is which date that you've been collecting this seed, and you should not use it or try to grow it too long. Don't keep it too long. So, and then you can put in the plastic bag, seal it nicely, or using the rubber band to tie it up, and then throw it into the chiller as well. So this way is the same thing that you can actually preserve the seed for about a year. I like to collect the seeds and share with the others. So what I'm gonna do is that I will collect in the big quantity and keep it into the chiller. For those that I want to share into the smaller quantity, I pack into the smaller plastic bag in a very little, maybe 5 packet, 10 packet each of variety, a lot of variety. And when it's finishing up, I will refill it again by bring out those what I reserve well, and then share it in a very small quantity inside the container, because the reason is that I don't want it to be out from the chiller for too long, and I want to keep the percentage of growth to be a better percentage. Okay, so the way of growing seed also is important, but that it will be too long of the video. What I'm gonna do is that I will share to you guys time to time on how each of individual vegetable preparation the seed to grow and do the seedling more effective way. That's it. I hope this video answer to your guys why actually the seed that you check out the expiring date, you buy it and then you grow it right away, why it doesn't really doing well. Okay, beside the way of you are doing seedling it, there is a certain things that is might like to make the progress of expiry is faster, especially the heat, especially the sun. Sometimes if the seed has been soaked in the water or touching the rain and it's already having the moist, actually when the moist started to coming in, the seed can actually progress to grow, but that's the moist from rain and in the package. So somehow ever, when the moist is go off, the seed actually die. So those are the factor that is from the first stage of why the seed does not doing well. Okay, and for the next part that I will be sharing on the each individual on how we actually doing the seedling, it will be another factor on preparing the soil will be a common soil for the first 1 or 2 weeks of the seedling. There's a common soil can be used, but after that the way of doing it is quite different and very interesting. So follow us on the YouTube channel and we will be uploading the video like this every Tuesday. And put it like this, some of the sharing, some of the hands-on we can have frequency. If you have any questions, try to put into the comment and share with me. I do my best on answering those with my experience 15 years with the agriculture. I will be able to help. Okay, thank you very much for today and enjoy. Bye-bye.